This is a red-shanked duke, native to Indochina, inhabiting the undisturbed evergreen, semi-evergreen, and limestone forests of East Central Laos and Northern and Central Vietnam. It is one of the three species of dock langurs. The gray-shanked and black-shanked are the other two. The different species of duke langurs can be distinguished by the color of their legs or shanks. Sometimes referred to as the costumed ape, the red-shanked duke langur is among the most colorful of primates. The monkey's yellow-orange face and ears appear to be powdered with theatrical makeup, and the eyelids appear to be dusted with a powder blue eyeshadow. Dark almond-shaped eyes view the world, and from a modest nose, tiny nostrils inhale the fragrance of the forest habitat. The garb of the red-shanked duke langur is strikingly stylish, jazzing up a black speckled gray coat that covers the back, crown of the head, and upper arms, is a chestnut-colored collar that separates the white neck from a black band that stretches between the shoulders. The monkey's generous pot belly is a shimmery silver color. Maroon-red fur on the lower legs leads one to think, imaginatively, that the primate may have slipped into a pair of colorful stockings. Red-shanked duke langurs are folivorous, that is, they are herbivores who specialize in eating mostly leaves. Young, tender leaves are their preference. However, they will also eat shoots, buds, seeds, flowers, and unripened fruit. They receive their water requirement through their diet. Messy eaters, they frequently drop their food to the forest floor below, and they routinely burp as their multi-chambered stomach uses bacteria to break down the cellulose in the leaves that they eat through the biological process known as fermentation, thereby creating gassy monkeys. But what these colorful primates might lack in dining etiquette, they make up in manners, often sharing their meals with others in their group. Active during daylight hours, red-shanked duke langurs, like all langurs, are diurnal. They travel in groups and appear to enjoy one another's company. Come nightfall, they sleep in carefully selected large trees that provide a thick, protective canopy. Communication within these langurs include touch, visual signals, and vocalizations. Group grooming is an important tactile activity that establishes strong social bonds, not only between mothers and their infants, but between all members of a group. The red-shanked duke langur is classified as endangered on the IUCN Red Lists of Threatened Species. In the last three generations, the species has experienced a decline of more than 50% due to forest loss and hunting, and the grim prediction is that the population will continue to decline at perhaps a greater pace. Humans present the greatest threat to this species through hunting, habitat destruction, and the illegal wildlife pet trade. The Vietnam War also had a detrimental impact on langur populations. In addition to having their habitat extensively bombed and sprayed with the toxic defoliant known as Agent Orange, soldiers used the monkeys for target practice. The red-shanked duke langur is listed in Appendix 1 of the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species, CITES, an international agreement between governments whose goal is to ensure that international trade in specimens of wild animals and plants does not threaten their survival. However, as is often the case with endangered species, laws created to protect them are largely ignored and difficult to enforce. And in Vietnam, conservation law enforcement is extremely weak. Even though the country has granted the red-shanked duke langur the highest protection status under its wildlife protection law.